This is a fly through my bandsaw sawmill CAD model. So we're going to fly through in what is normally the bottom of the case if it was upright. And you can see here the lower wheel and the blade on it. So we're now inside the case. And on the left, you can see the blade guide. That's the lower blade guide. Now we're just moving over the log and coming up, you can see the upper blade guide. And now we're going to zoom through the upper blade guard. That's a channel made out of metal. And now we're going to come out the top of the case. Now let's take another pass through, this time on the other side of the wheels. So here's the upper wheel and the blade as we're following it in here. And we're inside the actual housing right now. And you can see the teeth of the saw blade coming up right here. And now we're going through the channel, which is normally on the left of it. And above us, you can see the hinges for the actual enclosure. Now here's coming up on the motor pulley. And now we're going to take a pass out a hole in the enclosure, and this is the teeth of the actual vertical height adjustment sprocket. Now here's the thing that actually catches the sprocket, which locks the saw in a certain height. And now panning past the attachment for the height adjustment crank, and now zooming around, here you can see the cable as it winds onto the shaft. It's held on with hose clamps. And now let's follow that cable down. And you can see where it attaches to the actual saw frame. So this is how it pulls it up and down. Now let's zoom out another hole in the enclosure. And here's the back end of the log. Now backing off a little bit, you can see the back of the mill. And let's pan around to the front. And yeah, that's the sawmill. Now, what's cool about this sawmill design is the actual cutter head is a bandsaw on its own. So you just mount a table to it, and you can put it even on top of your bench top, and it's a regular 14-inch bandsaw, although one with a relatively large cutting capacity. And here you can see the top is a tensioner. It needs to be fairly robust for the heavy blades. And panning around to the front of it. So that fly through I was just showing was generated using a CAD model using the free version of Google SketchUp 8. And that CAD model is included in the plan. So this is actually the file that's in the plan, and it has all kinds of different views. So every one of the drawings that is in the plans is actually part of the CAD model. And the cool thing is you see a drawing like this and you see all the parts. Well, even this drawing here is actually a 3D model. So I can pan around this 3D model and look at it from the back. And even some of the other views, the 2D views. So let's go through the scene manager. So we have all of the drawings here, and we pop up, say, one of the 2D views. So this is for cutting out and pasting onto your plans. Even this is actually a 3D model because I can rotate around that, and now you can see the parts are actually 3D. I just project them flat so that you get the one-to-one template.